This is Prophetess Cebile coming to you from 7750 Media. Today is the 26th of May, 2024, and I want to go through some notes that I made on the 22nd of May, 2022. And remember, the number 22 for me, unless I say otherwise, is about Isaiah 22:22, the key of David, which opens doors and shuts doors. And it's also the key that the Lord operates in order to open up options and close off options. It's also the key that he uses to give access to information or shut down access to information, if I can put it that way. So I was watching the program on Netflix, the documentary that was done on the hacking of a dating site and company called Ashley Madison. And there are certain things that I picked up in order to advance the ministry of 7750 with the topics that the Lord has given me to cover. So there was a comment that was made by one of the commentators that narcissistic sociopaths will always cheat, and there is nothing that anybody can do about them because they suck up the validation that they get from the women that they sleep with. When Ashley Madison was hacked, it was just a bomb that was waiting to go off because they were basically given a period of time within which to shut down their website. Otherwise, the information was going to be leaked. And there's a song I hear. It goes, I'm coming out. I want the world to know. Now, it sounds to me like there's a person that wants to come out with certain information, but I don't know what the Lord is referring to. But it will become clear because obviously I would not be talking about Ashley Madison if it has no relevance to what I'm discussing. There was a Christian man by the name of Sam Rader who expressed how his character and reputation were completely decimated when his name appeared in the Ashley Madison lists. The hookups that were arranged through the dating website were one night stands, one week stands, however long. And basically a man or a woman could sign up and explore with different types of hookups, I guess, depending on their sexual fantasies. But when the hack happened, celebrities were exposed in public. And the one journalist was actually just saying that it was the sole purpose of Ashley Madison was adultery. And in the olden days, if a woman was exposed for adultery, she would be issued with a scarlet letter. But obviously, in the modern day, there are no consequences, or so people think, for committing adultery, except perhaps just suffering from the cancer of shame. Ashley Madison had promised its clients protection, that their information would never be leaked. So it encouraged people, it gave people safety in living dishonestly. But in a matter of a few hours, years of betrayals were exposed. The sloppy behavior of sexual predators was exposed. Destruction came to many because some people actually committed suicide once their names were out there. Sam Raider reflected on how, as a man, he had never really had to dig deep inside himself and examine his own heart of darkness. He'd never really had to take accountability or responsibility for his behavior, living a double life with a wife and children on the one hand, and living out his sexual fantasies on a dating app, sleeping with different women. The one journalist was actually just talking about how everyone wants to know what's going on in everybody's sex life, and that people want to know if their favorite celebrity was having an affair. People want to know what politicians are doing in their bedrooms. Evan Beck, who was the sales vice president of Ashley Madison, was discussing how, as long as men have penises, you know, Ashley Madison will always be in business. Noel Biderman, who was the CEO of Ashley Madison, was totally exposed and disgraced, having been a man who presented himself outwardly as a man who believed in monogamy, which was just absolutely ridiculous to me, pretending to be a family man when, in fact, why would you agree to be in this type of environment and be the CEO of it if you are also not indulging yourself with that kind of lifestyle? Now, the Lord says that there comes a time when he has to deal decisively with a matter that he has purposed to deal with. A man or a woman cannot make a hobby out of having sex with the wives of other men or the husbands of other women and believe that there are no consequences for that. Joe Biden's son denied involvement with Ashley Madison, though his name was part of the list that was exposed for at least registering on the site. I must tell you, I just got the creeps as I was watching that whole program, because I was like, Lord, why are you bringing this to my attention? But one thing I have learned over years and years of God giving me dreams and visions and revelations is that there is nothing that God will take me to that has no bearing in what I'm doing, which is ministry. So he will not talk about dating sites and strip clubs, and he will not expose me to that unless it has a direct bearing on what's coming next, if I can put it that way. The Ashley Madison files are still being spoken about today, because obviously the fact that this documentary has been done has brought the matter back to life again. I think I have laid a foundation, or I've laid a background for what's coming next, because obviously there is some relevance to the fact that the Lord is talking about information systems being hacked and people being exposed, despite the fact that they were promised confidentiality, they were promised absolute privacy. And in fact, in South Africa specifically, there is the POPIA Act, which is being quoted left, right, and center as protecting people's personal information in various spheres. Let me leave this here for now. I'll be back. Thanks for listening. Thanks for watching.